Hello, folks. Welcome back to our Intel Graphics Performance Analyzers video series, Intel GPA Framework Quick Tips. Pamela Harrison here, back with more insights for how to use Intel GPA Framework to help with your profiling workflow. Today, I am excited to introduce my colleague and our GPA Vulkan expert, Patrick Purcell. He will show you how to get started with Intel Graphics Performance Analyzers utilities for Vulkan, or as we like to call it, GVK. We are releasing this quick tip in August because of Vulkanalia, the Vulkan API's namesake. Patrick implemented the GVK project in order to empower Vulkan developers by assisting them in writing Vulkan-compliant code. GVK is a completely open-source project available on GitHub that lowers the barrier of entry to working with Vulkan by providing developer-friendly abstractions. Here's Patrick.
Thanks, Pamela. The first thing that I'm going to talk about is GVK's reference-based lifetime management for Vulkan handles. For example, VK frame buffer is a complex object. It references a VK render pass and a variable number of VK image views that each themselves reference a VK image. VK image also references a VK device memory, but I'm not going to be covering that here. Do know that GVK integrates AMD's VMA or Vulkan memory allocator to handle memory allocations. The lifetime of each of these objects must be carefully managed to ensure the validity of the VK frame buffer. This can be achieved by simply creating and destroying all of these resources together, but that's not always practical. GVK's lifetime semantics ensure that as long as the VK frame buffer is in use, the VK render pass, VK image views, and VK images remain valid. This makes resource sharing between different systems very straightforward by moving the responsibility for lifetime management from a resource ownership model to a scope model. As long as something is in scope, all of its dependencies remain in scope. Let's take a look at some code. Assuming that we've already created a valid GVK image, which is created using a VK image create info, we will then go and populate the fields for our image view create info using the information from the image. We will populate the image view create info in much the same way if we were not using GVK. You will notice that we use GVK get default to get the image view create info. This is going to set its S type. There is a get default for every Vulkan structure that sets S types and some sensible default values where appropriate. We will be calling GVK image view create. This function is similar to VK create image view, other than the fact that it takes GVK handles as opposed to raw Vulkan handles. Once we have created the image view using the GVK image, the GVK image is referenced by the GVK image view. As long as the image view stays in scope or is referenced by another object that stays in scope, such as a GVK frame buffer, the image will stay valid. There is no need for user code to maintain an explicit handle to the GVK image. Once we have a valid GVK handle to an object, we can retrieve its create info, we can retrieve other objects that it references, and we can retrieve its parent. Note here that we are getting the VK image view create info from the image view. We can also retrieve a reference to the image, we can also retrieve the device, the physical device, and the instance. The second thing that I'll talk about is how GVK can simplify resource creation. VK pipeline layout and VK descriptor set layout are both used to describe the interface of a VK pipeline. These objects are tedious and error prone to write by hand. GVK provides utilities for creating these objects from SpurV using SpurV cross for shader reflection. GVK also provides utilities for compiling SpurV via GL slang. Paired with the reference semantics, working with VK pipeline layout and VK descriptor set layout becomes easily manageable. In this code example, we are creating a GVK SpurV binding info, and then simply populating the binding info with our vertex shader info and our fragment shader info. These objects are populated with SpurV that is compiled from GLSL using GL slang. Here, using a SpurV binding info and a render pass, we will create a pipeline layout. The render pass is any render pass that will be compatible with the pipeline that we are going to create this pipeline layout for. After creating the pipeline layout will provide an array of descriptor set layouts. The descriptor set layouts were created for us automatically using the SpurV binding info. It's simple to loop over the descriptor set layouts and process those as necessary. The last thing that I'm going to discuss today is GVK's basic layer. This can be extended to create your own custom Vulkan layers. Intel GPA uses custom Vulkan layers built on GVK's basic layer for state tracking within the Frame Analyzer tool. The sample layer that builds with GVK is rudimentary and simply listens for the creation of an instance, a device, and the allocation of memory. But from there, very powerful tools can be built. GVK provides additional functionality not covered here. For example, stringification for all Vulkan structures, utilities for parsing the Vulkan XML and generating C++ code, and IMGUI integration. See the links below for more information. Try out GVK today. Thanks for watching. Check back soon for our next episode of Intel GPA Framework Quick Tips. Remember to like this video and subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel. And to learn more about this topic, follow the links in the description.